Chapter 28, Amplifier Basics. After completing this chapter, you're going to be able to describe the purpose of an amplifier. Identify the three basic configurations of transistor amplifier circuits. Identify the classes of amplifiers. Describe the operation of direct coupled amplifiers, audio amplifiers, video amplifiers, RF amplifiers, IF amplifiers, and operational amplifiers. Draw and label schematic diagrams for the different types of amplifier circuits. Amplifier configuration. Transistor can be connected in three different circuit configurations. Common base, common emitter, common collector circuit. In these different configurations, one lead serves as a common reference point, and the other two leads serve as input and output connections. Each configuration can be constructed using either NPN or PNP transistors. The transistor, not transmitter, transistor emitter-based junction is going to be forward biased. The collector-based junction is reverse biased. Well, that's how we turn a transistor on, right? So this should be reviewed. This is nothing new. Each configuration has its advantages and disadvantages. The common emitter circuit is the most widely used throughout the industry. This table here shows us some of the common attributes associated with the three different configurations. This is a great table to know how to find in your book. Since the common emitter is the most common, let's first take a look at the common emitter. Input resistance, or impedance if you prefer, for common emitter is medium. Common base is low, common collector is high. So an engineer may say, I've got a medium input impedance, I got to feed it into this amplifier. How am I going to get proper impedance matching? I'm going to have to use a common emitter configuration. Or an engineer may say, I've got a high input impedance, what do I plug it into? What's the first component? Well, to match the input, it has to be a common collector configuration. Output resistance or impedance, again, for common emitter is medium, for the common base and the common collector, you can see high and low. Voltage gain, medium for common emitter, high for common base, common collector, less than one. Well, to understand that, you have to understand how when you're putting a waveform in and it's in that bias configuration, you're basically going to get phase inversion. It has to do with how you're biasing the device. But check this out. Common collector, you put in 1 volt, you get out less than 1. Doesn't sound like amplifying to me, does it? But in actuality it is, because what are we doing here as far as current gain? Current gain is going to be medium. So though we don't get voltage gain, we're going to get medium current gain. Look at our common base that had a high voltage gain. The current gain is going to be less than 1. But don't forget, all we're doing is amplifying here. We're not making or destroying power. We can't do that. We can't do that. All we can do is harness it. So when we come here to power gain, the highest power gain is common emitter. Common base is medium with less than 1 current gain, high voltage gain. Common collector, medium power output, medium current gain, less than 1 voltage gain. If you needed an amplifier that, like a public address system inside of a building, PA system, typically uses higher voltage, like 70 volts, is what a PA system is. okay? So if we're driving a PA system, had an amplifier PA system, we're going to drive speakers at 70 volts, which configuration do you think we'd probably end up using here? Yeah, very good. High voltage gain. 70 volts would be a high voltage gain, so we're probably going to use common base to be the output driving transistors in that amplifier circuit. So you got to look at what you're doing and what the application is. That's why, again, this table is invaluable. John Reddy noticed down below here, common base, you put in a small AC signal, you get out a large AC signal. Common emitter, you put in a small AC signal, you get out an inverted large AC signal. Common collector, you put in a small AC signal, you get out actually a small. It looks the same, but it's actually going to be smaller. It's going to be a little bit less than what you put in the way. But the nice thing about this is you get some medium current gain. So maybe you need that current to drive some other device or what have you. So does this kind of make sense to you? Different configurations for different applications. All transistors are not put in the circuit the same way. All are not treated equally. Amplifier biasing. How do we turn a transistor on so that we could bias a transistor? All configurations of transistor amplifier circuits require two voltages. The first voltage is the base emitter junction, and we're going to forward bias that. The next is going to be the base collector junction. That's going to be reverse biased. Both voltages can be provided by the same source. Okay, because it's just how we're taking them in reference to the output. Right? A 9-volt battery will give you 9 volts out, right? It'll also give you a negative 9 volts out if you hook it up backwards. So that's what we're saying. One of the problems that we're faced with amplifiers, because we use transistors, is thermal instability. Thermal instability. Temperature change causes transistors' internal resistance to change. The bias currents change. The operating point of the transistor shifts. The gain of the transistor is going to be reduced. To compensate for temperature changes, we feed a portion of the unwanted signal back into the circuit input. This is feedback. This is intentional feedback, and this is good, because what it's going to do is help stabilize that output so that it's not prone to instability due to temperature change. Another thing that we're covering in this chapter are classes of amplifiers. Classes of amplifiers. The first amplifier we're going to talk about is Class A amplifier. Class A amplifier is biased so that the current flows throughout the entire cycle. So if you put in a 360-degree sine wave, you get out a 360-degree sine wave. Because of this, it's considered to be the most linear. You put in a small sine wave, you get out a big sine wave. It produces the least amount of distortion. The least amount of distortion. Why? Because you put in a small one, you get out a big one. It also has lower output ratings, so we can't really get high levels of amplification out of this. It's the least efficient. Applications include radios and televisions. Why? If you're listening to the radio, you usually like to listen to a clean, clear sound. If you're watching the TV, you typically want to see a nice, clean image. That's why you watch it. Class AB amplifier is biased so that the output current flows for less than a full cycle, but more than a half cycle. So you put 360 in, you're going to get something more than 180 out, but less than 360. Because of this, it's going to produce a substantial amount of distortion. What you're putting in, you're not entirely getting back out. Class B amplifiers are biased so that the output current flows for only half of the input cycle. You put 360 in, you get 180 out. You're only amplifying half of it. This fact will produce a substantial amount of distortion. It's used as output stages in stereo systems, public address amplifiers, and in many industrial control applications. Class C amplifiers are biased so that the output current flows for less than half of the input AC input cycle. Put in 360, get less than 180 out. Produces a substantial amount of distortion. This is used to amplify RF signals used in radio and television transmission. You might think that because you're getting less than half out, you know, radio and television, it would be all distorted. No. The information, the content is intact, but the RF signal itself is what is reduced. But because these transmitters are much more efficient, it's basically engineered around so that the amount of output power you get is appropriate for the application. For radio and television, you don't need to get the entire cycle out in order for it to be an efficient broadcast. There are different classes of amplifiers, and there's three different configurations, common base, common collector, and common emitter. One of the things that we're going to have to do a lot is couple one amplifier to another amplifier. And to do so, we're going to use amplifier coupling. It's used to obtain greater amplification. The coupling method used must not disrupt the operation of the circuit, of either circuit. And there's really four different methods. There's a resistive capacitive or RC coupling. This is used primarily in audio amplifiers. Typically what they'll use is an electrolytic capacitor. And by the way, when I look at a circuit and I see a capacitor, I think of really two things. Charging to a DC level and blocking DC and passing AC. So I see a cap in a circuit, that's what I look at. If I see a big 2 farad capacitor in the trunk of a vehicle, I think powering a subwoofer. But generally, when I see a capacitor in a circuit, I'm thinking blocking DC, passing AC. That's what we use them for. And that's how we would use RC coupling to allow an AC signal to pass stage, but blocking the DC. The low frequency limit is going to be determined by the size of the capacitor. The high frequency limit is going to be determined by the type of the transistor used. Is it a high frequency transistor or not? Another method of coupling is impedance coupling. This is where we're going to use an inductor instead of a resistor. The inductor consumes less power than the resistor. The overall efficiency of the circuit is going to be increased. It's used when a very narrow band of frequencies must be amplified. Transformer coupled circuit can effectively match a high impedance source to a low impedance load. Only useful for a narrow band of frequencies. And then there's direct coupling, used to amplify very low frequencies or a DC signal. provides a uniform current and voltage gain over a wide range of frequencies, but it's not very stable. In summary, amplifiers are electronic circuits used to increase the amplitude of an electronic circuit. The transistor is the primary amplifying device. The three different common configurations that are used are common base, common collector, and common emitter. Common collector amplifiers are used for impedance matching. Common emitter amplifiers provide phase reversal of input and output signals. A single voltage source can be provide the forward and reverse bias voltages using a voltage divider arrangement. A transistor amplifier can be biased so that all or part of the input signal is present at the output. Let's go through these real quick. Class A, 360 in, 360 out. Class AB, 360 in, greater than 180, less than 360 out. Class B, 360 in, only half out. Class C, 360 in, less than half out. Those are the numbers you got to remember. A, AB, B, and C. Coupling methods include resistive capacitive coupling, or RC coupling, very common. Impedance coupling, great for a narrow band of frequencies, used as an inductor. Transformer coupling, indirect coupling. Direct couple amps are used for high gain at low frequencies, or again, amplification of a DC signal. Chapter 28. Any questions at all on anything we covered in Chapter 28?